successful. Let me tell you what to do. I'm a great one, city. It's your turn to jump. Okay. If you want to be successful, let me tell you what to do. I'm a great one, city. It's your turn to jump. If I get knocked down, they might even say you're crazy. Something to leave on, babe. And jump as far as you can. And when you look around, look how high you're soaring. Jump, jump, even if you're nervous. It's your turn to jump, jump, but I can get hurry. It's your turn to act like a success. Be part of success. In order to become the best.
You know what time it is? Short Hair Boot Camp Live. Give y'all a second to log on.
Oh, yeah. Act like a success. Think like a
hey.
In order to become the best,
act like a success.
All right, you guys, we're logging on 3 minutes after. Camera's not on yet. Let's get you guys squared away. Some people can't log on. Hands up if you're with it. Let me see. I think we have some tech support issues. 1 second, y'all. Let me get you guys the right link. Okay, you guys, it is saying, I see some of you guys saying, hey, I see some of you guys saying that you can't log in. I see some logged in. I see some in an old one. So I see you guys logging in, and I see some of you have an old one. Not sure how it happens. That's just the tech world. I posted in the Facebook group. Oh, yeah. I posted in the Facebook group the link. So let me tag you guys. There we go. Let me just tag a few of you guys on Facebook. Come on and start today. Good morning, good morning, good morning, everyone. So, I'm making sure everybody get in. I'm getting a bunch of panic messages right now. So let me not let y'all panic. Let me help you out. Uno momento. I don't want to wake up feeling sad, putting on my makeup, because I hate. Okay, so let me see. If you cannot log in, or if you're getting taken back to an old screen, you have to refresh. A lot of times, if you've been to the same link, no matter what you're on, the computer starts to try to think for you, and it will take you back to the old class. So you got to always clear your cache, your browser, your internet history, because it keeps things fresh and updated. So I'm gonna give you guys another second to do that. Got some juicy stuff for y'all today. I'm excited. I love, love, love live classes. I need your energy. So let me see if I can move this. I gotta move. There we go. Anyway, I'm excited to have you. And I'm gonna give you guys like 2 seconds to log in. I see some of you are getting it. Let's see. Make sure y'all good. I don't want you to miss it. Johanna, I hope you got it. Let's see. My Facebook inbox is depressing, just so y'all know. That is not the place to send support. That's not the place to send support questions. It will get lost. If you're already in the chat room, say what's up. Brandy, not sure how you're not in. I don't know what's going on. I got some people in, some people not in. If you're in the chat room, say what's up. I don't know why y'all can't get on. I'm showing people are here, they're registered. So only thing I can say is just refresh your screen. X off, log back into Short Hair Bootcamp Live, refresh, and then sign in. Let's see. I'm showing people logging in, so I know the link isn't broken. But I'm gonna give y'all a second. Let's see. Can't get on. Let me see what's going on, y'all. It's showing me that you are able to get on. Let's see. Yeah, I'm showing it live, guys. So we're about to get started. I'm gonna give y'all a few more seconds. You're in the chat room, say what's up. There we go. Hi, I got in from the link on Facebook. I'm in, thank you. Hey, LaTanya. Hey, Rainy. Johanna, yay. Okay, y'all got it. I'm gonna give like a couple more seconds. I see a couple people trying to send messages. Let's see if you guys got it. I'm hold on, y'all. I'm doing tech support. And guys, this live streams, before it goes private, it live streams on YouTube. So I'm sure you probably could just go to YouTube at this point. I see Brandy Nelson. Hey, Keisha, can't see you. Oh, that's not the same. It's so many Brandys. Let's see what's going on. All right. Hold on, we're gonna get started in a second. 11 minutes after. I just want to make sure people get on. You guys are somewhere in, somewhere. Johanna, Rainley. Okay. Okay, so good morning to everybody. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I'm doing all these chat rooms. Monet, I need you here. I don't know why I didn't have you here today. So, today is exciting. Hey, Tammy. I see you guys getting in. Okay. I see you guys getting in. So today, I get this question so much. I feel like it's very appropriate to go ahead and address today so that everybody has clarity. And this is, it's like college. You go to class every week, you know, three times a week. You go for 6 and 8 weeks and you repeat the same thing and you go over different ways to go over the same thing, the bigger picture, right? So that's what Short Hair Bootcamp Live. If this is your first time in Short Hair Bootcamp Live, please say what's up. Like, let me know. I'm so excited to have you. If this is your 50th time, thank you to the VIPs, okay? So I just want to say good morning to everyone. It's only 9:13 here in Cali, so it could be, what is New York? It's almost, you know, noon. But I just want to say that I appreciate each and every one of you. I'm excited to have you. I love to share. It's never a bad question. Whatever question you want to ask, like, that's what I'm here for. And so it's my honor, my pleasure. So today I wanted to go over this question because we get so many in the inbox. Let's see, making sure I'm answering all these questions. I got like 3-4 screens up right now. We get so many questions about how to assess and how to feel confident when someone brings in a picture. I'm trying to figure out why Miss Gwen is not in. Let's see, hold on, y'all. So everybody sends a message and they want to know how to confidently execute a picture that a client brings in. So, oh, look at my cute nephews. So, we're going to go over what that looks like when you are assessing and having a consultation with a client. What up, Johan? It's your first live class. Yo, right now, let me know where you're from in the chat box right now, whether you're on YouTube, whether you're on this hangout, the private hangout. Like, let me know where you're from, because that always excites me, because everybody be in such random places and it just gives me so much energy. What's up, Johanna? So let me know where you're from in the chat room right now. But what I'm going to talk about is how to do these things confidently, how to execute. That is, guys, our confidence is the key. It's a big, 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 big part of your business, because if you're not confident, if you're always questioning yourself, it's gonna show up in your work and your clients are gonna feel it and they're not gonna come back to you. And this is about customer retention. So Knoxville, Tennessee, what up? Hey, I was in Knoxville. So this is a big deal, because if you're not confident, then your customer, they feed off your energy. Like, literally, guys, I am very clear that I sell energy more so than I sell, you know, hairstyles or whatever. There's always somebody better than you. There are plenty of hairstylists better than me. There are plenty of better than me type whatever, but I sell energy. I let them know that I love what I do. I'm here to serve them. I want to execute what they ask for. And as it relates to their head shape, their body shape, their face structure, right? And you have to be able to be confident enough to break down a look and then go over, you know, the different things that they like about it, and then assess them. And when you assess them, you can't assess them and make them feel like they don't have, or they aren't, like, you gotta do it. This is a little process, okay? And what happens during that process is that you begin to build trust and they begin to view you as the expert, but it's all about your delivery. I promise you, if you go to LaKeishaMichelle.genbook.com, you'll see my reviews. Like, I don't make that up. I don't pay people to say it. But for the most part, they're, you know, like, wow, like, it was, she was so nice, and she was so, because I'm communicating, okay? So you can't please everybody. Get that in your mind, because I don't please everybody. I'm not for everyone, and I'm very clear. When a client doesn't fit, I let them know. Don't, me, you and I are not going to have a good working relationship, because, you know, it just, you can't please everybody. But for the people that are for me, the people that I've attracted, my dream customers that I attract from YouTube on a weekly basis, we develop a relationship, and it all starts here. It all starts at the consultation when they bring in that picture. Now, here's the thing about bringing in pictures. Is this the class for October 4th, Keisha? It's Brandy Jackson. Yes, Brandy. Hi, love. So, okay, you're in. Come back, please. Love a class close to here. Yes, 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 yes. I plan on doing a lot of that next year. Johanna, I plan on doing a lot of that next year. So, anyway, back to this. So this, the consultation brings a relationship, and it elevates you to the expert, right? Now, let me just say, let's just rewind and let's just bring it on in. If you want to be seen as an expert, I know that you probably already know this, but we're going to go over it again. If you want to be seen as an expert, what do experts look like? And if we don't know, when in doubt, just Google. Just what does an expert hairstylist look like? Like, Google it if you really don't know, if you need some better examples. But an expert hairstylist has on, now I'm not saying go to work with your face beat down to the gauze, like they say, like you don't have to do that if that's not who you are, right? It's all about being authentic, but also being professional. And so don't look like you, if you know you have big dark circles and that's just who you are, accept it and then do a little something to make sure you look awake, okay? Put some BB cream on, do something. If you know, okay, you dang sure need to have your hair done, like, period. You gotta have, the best part about my business now is I don't have to do my hair, yay! But when I first started out, I was building a clientele. It's a must to have your hair done. It's a must to wear the t-shirts with my business on the back that says Sassy Cuts and Color, LaKeisha Michelle. Like, it's a must to always be in, you know, ready to market. And so, in order to be seen as an expert, in order for people to believe and trust in you during that consultation process, it's extremely important to look the part. And because that's your first impression. And so when a new customer comes in, or when your regular customer comes in and they have a picture, a part of you selling you and what you know how to do is looking the part. So guys, that's extremely important. You know, if you smoke, don't nobody want to smell your smoke breath. Check it. Don't nobody want to, you know, smell your breath, period. How about that? Because you may not smoke, but you may have it. You like, these are basics, but it's so, so, so important. You know, and you just have to make sure, and when I work with L'Oreal Matrix, we always talked about having a clean eye in your area. Like your station, your area needs to be clean. If it's cluttery, that's unconscious, like, it makes people feel nervous. It makes people, you know, panic, you know, and they don't even know they're panicking, but they just feel like, you know, you really don't have time, you know, or you're just like all over the place and it's not calm. So you want to make sure that first you're looking the parts, because it's not about you, it's about them, but you need to be seen as an expert. And experts are authority figures, and they are, you know, that's the boss. So, that's number one. Number two is make sure your area is very clean. Make sure it's opening and welcoming for a consultation before that client, okay? So, very important. And then you have to speak with authority and confidence. Even if you don't have it, you need to fake it till you make it. Lean on me. If you don't have confidence, when somebody brings your picture that gets on your nerves, it makes you nervous because you feel like you cannot achieve whatever, don't panic. Just think, you know, okay, I'm going to play like I'm Keisha for today, and I'm going to make this happen. And so, like, I did that all the time. I used to literally think about my mentor, and I was like, you know what? I'm just going to lean on her confidence because I don't have it right now, and I know that I'm not good at this haircut, but I'm going to act like her. And when she's in this stage of the consultation, she does this, this, and this, and I'm going to act like her. Okay, alter ego, Sasha Fierce. Okay, and then eventually you are Sasha Fierce. Beyonce is Sasha Fierce now, right? So, yay, Gwen's in. Yay, you're in, mama. Okay, so here's the deal. I get this question a lot, like I was telling you guys, and it's always, how do I feel confident? So one way to feel confident is by always, always, always practicing. If you only spend 30 minutes a day, even if it's just 30 minutes a day, that 30 minutes in 2 months will make you feel insanely like a pro, okay? So practicing makes you feel confident, because then when you get in front of that person, because this is fresh on your mind, because you watched this 100 times, like, can I say something? I know we got like 30 videos in the Short Hair Bootcamp Live area. You gotta pick one thing and perfect it, and then go to the next. It doesn't mean watch 30, like, you gotta pick one thing and perfect it. You need to do this with your eyes closed, and then be like, word next bit. And then do this with your eyes closed. You see this cut we did, like, what, 2 weeks ago? Like, if this ain't mastered, there's no need to look for new information. Like, master that. Like, your clients should lay upside down and have this funky cut. Like, look at that. That's all so cray-cray and just texture and just crazy, crazy good looking, right? That's the cut that we did. Like, this is what we, this is, I haven't done anything to this since we did that live class, right? And you can create tons of stuff from this cut. And you can take this cut 7 different ways. So don't get caught up in the number of videos or, you gotta get caught up in the technique, okay? So I'm gonna make her back cute right here. You'll sit right there, girl. I forgot what we named her. But anyway, so we're talking about having a clean eye. Your area needs to be clean. When someone's eye hits your area, it needs to be clean. If it's too much going on, it's gonna make their nerves bad, okay? We talked about your first impression. How you look, you have to look the part in order to tell somebody what they can and can't do, right? Because when customers come in with that picture, you know how they do. They already got their mindset on it, and that's just what they want, and that is it. So you have to be able to communicate. You got to be able to listen to what they're saying, and here's where the breakdowns happen. When a customer is explaining to you, and so what I did was go through the messages that you guys send on different pictures. I get this picture a lot. This is Kamandi. What up, Kamandi? Love her work. She's in Dallas. And a lot of my friends have been in her class, like, amazing stylist. So when you, first of all, be confident in you, because when people bring in other people's pictures that are very, very popular, either you're gonna be excited, because I love her work, I admire her work, or you're gonna be intimidated. And so the intimidation comes from the knowledge that I just spoke on, which is just all you gotta do is practice. So what we're gonna talk about today is assessing a picture and looking at the person and having that conversation, okay? So, oh wait, let me do this, guys. Hold on 1 second. And I actually love to do these type of consultations, because this is where, like I said, this is where you really build a relationship. This is truly where you build the relationship, because once you break down the picture to the customer, the way that I'm gonna show you how I do, they trust you. And when they trust you, you can do more. You can be more. You can be you and create the way you need to create, the way you know how. Okay, so, hey, Brittany. I'm new, I'm excited. Hi, Brittany, yay! I just love y'all. I'm gonna have to do like a trial. I'll keep things to touch screen. I'm gonna have to do the thing where I just go meet everybody in different parts of the US, because it's exciting. So like I said, this is Kamandi, guys. If I recommend, go and like stalk her work. Her work is beautiful. So first things first, when someone brings me a picture, I love to welcome the picture. So y'all write that down. Make sure y'all take notes. We talked about this for those of you just joining. We talked about having a clean eye, which is your area needs to be on point. Do not have a bunch of clutter, 50 brushes, an orange neon comb, a blue comb, a red. We need clean eyes, okay? Put your shears in a shear case. Put them in the drawer until you're using them. Put your combs away. Guys, make sure things are neat. When you have that consultation, it is about the client, and it is they need to see minimal, because if it's a bunch of everywhere, makes your nerves bad, okay? So we talked about your first impression, being looking professional. We're talking about now gathering information and listening to the customer. So they're going to bring in this picture, and they're probably going to have like 50 pictures. They're going to be like, well, I like this one. And then I like this one. And then, you know, I like that. And then they're going to bring another one. They're going to say, well, you know, I like this. But, you know, I really don't. I'm professional, so I can't do that. So no spikes. But I want that. And I don't like that. But I like that. And I need that. But I want it long. Like, they just go down. They don't even know. Like, they just go, oh, yeah, make my bang like that. Even though I want it like that. Like, that's what they do. They give you a long and short in a matter of seconds. And you guys, we have to know how to maneuver that conversation. So I'm looking at the comments, making sure you guys are, yep, you guys are straight. Okay, so here's what happens when they come in and do that. I say, oh my God, that is so cute. First of all, let's always, always, always agree with the customer. Guys, when you agree with the customer, it will bring their guards down, okay? So make sure y'all take notes, get your pen together. Give y'all a second, go get that pen, get your paper. Because if you have a little index card as a reminder, and this is, it's hard because when people come in, like I said, you either are on defense or offense. And so get your little card, rule number one, first impression. Number two, clean eye. Number three, listen and gather information. Number four, agree with the customer. Always agree with the customer, period. That's gonna make a happy customer. Don't nobody care what you think is hot right now, because it's not about you. You're selling the service to them. So understand, agree with your customer, and then go through the style with them and see what they like about it. Always. So what I do is say, okay, what do you like? Well, she's going to say, oh, I love this. I like the waves, but I think that's too short. But I don't do spikes, but I want this look. Like, I like that. So give me something. Typically, they may, even people that are gung-ho and say, I want this style. Here's where you change, you listen and you not change your mind, but you let them know, like, what about this makes this pop? So because I've studied probably 10,000 hours of hair pictures, literally, I'm talking about myself, all I do is study pictures, I can assess instantly what makes this picture pop. First of all, she has a small head. I actually know her. I know this lady. She has a small head. So always look at the head shape as it relates to your customer. Because some people would be like, my head is deceiving. My head is very big, long. So like certain styles, it's either gonna make my head look bigger or longer banana shape. So certain things do and don't work. So you have to know. And knowing what your head shape is will actually help you. Even with makeup or whatever, like knowing where you are on the charts helps you gauge other face shapes. So that's why as a beauty professional, it's really great to know yourself, because even with makeup, for example, let me just show how to connect what I'm, why I'm saying that. With foundation, I know what level color foundation I am. So if I'm looking at her, I can automatically start to guess where she is and test, I can pick, you know, two or three colors and test, and one of them are gonna match like that because I know me, right? So use you as a guide, right? And you may be like super darker than her or super light than her. It's still gonna help you gauge. Same thing with hair. You know, look at the face shape. If you're not good with face shapes, start to go get a bunch of pictures and look at different shapes. Look at the length. Look at how this sticks out in relation to this area. Is there a long shape there? She has a pretty small oval shaped head, guys. You see that? See the point there? You see that? It's like a little oval at the top, goes to a point. So she can pretty much, oval face shapes can pretty much wear anything, right? So first things first, what makes this pop? Start to do that when you see a picture. This, all of that, that makes this pop, okay? We have spikes here. We have different directions. Lots of little pixie spikes. That makes this pop. This, excuse me, this point here complements this point here very nicely. Okay? This, remember we call this in the classes the Valentine. Y'all remember I always say this looks like an upside down heart. This heart complements this area of her face. It brings it all together. It makes it sweet. It makes it feminine. That's why I call it the Valentine. Another, this makes it sweet, makes it feminine, makes the ear look sexy. This makes the neck look sexy. So looking at a picture, you need to train yourself to be able to look and see what makes a hairstyle pop. I actually went through, like I said, messages and saved the most pictures. I get a lot of Kamandi's work. Her work is amazing. So I figure let's assess. If you really look at this picture, it's not that much different than the one we just looked at. You have the Valentine's sweet area here, little spike there. Again, she has a small head. So the point here at the very bottom right there complements this section, the symmetry, all of that goes together. Okay? So first thing I do is just look and see what's popping. All the pictures have the feminine sweetheart line. All right? And then they have like a little nice, messy, it looks soft, it looks touchable, and it's just kind of tussled through. These are not like hard row-by-row curls. So go through, guys, and learn how to assess what it is that's happening here, and then think out loud to the customer. So what I would do is say, oh, okay, these are soft, they're messy. I see you like the waves on the side. Okay, see on this one, what do you like about that? And I would tell them, that's a tussled style. You have to talk through this because a lot of times customers like her face and they're not really looking at the hairstyle. That's why you gotta talk through pictures. A lot of times they were like, I wanna look like her because she cute. She got makeup on, all of that. She got a little down here, like she's cute. So I wanna look like her. They're not really looking at the style. So you gotta look at your customer and be able to tell what they're excited about when it comes to the picture. And so, again, soft wave outline, it's messy. It's textured. It looks like you could just run your hands through it. These are not hard curls. It's interesting because you gotta have the conversation with the person to say, are you looking for, like, this is tussle. This is running your hands through. You know, this is like kind of pixie up here, just messy, soft curls with a wave outline. Start to title things because then customers, they'll start learning what they like about the pictures and it helps them communicate to you what they like and what they want to see on themselves. And so I did this just to show you, like, on these pictures, there's a formula. When you look at pictures, you can start learning how to formulate what makes it dope. Instantly, when we look at this, what makes this dope, guys? In the chat room, what makes this dope? Tell me, I know that there's a delay. In the chat room, what makes this pop right now? Because you gotta start being able to look at pictures and say, they like it because, first of all, like I said, she's cute. So without her and these lashes and this pink lipstick that just automatically make you wanna go put on makeup, the obvious parts are the outline. So back to molding 101, understanding the mold and framing the face. Face framing is so, boom, Latanya, you bomb, Brittany, you bomb, Alexis, you bomb, Brandy, you bomb, y'all bomb, I see you. So perfect, face framing. Do we not, I keep thinking it's a touchscreen. Do we not talk about that all the time? All the time. So Lynn, you get in the chat room, babe, by logging into shorthairbootcamplive.com. But I actually can see your chats right here. So, but the chat room that they're speaking from is on shorthairbootcamplive.com. You log in and you'll see live class. Click that, log in, boom, you're inside. So now that we kind of get, we're going to go through a couple more pictures as an exercise. So that's just Kamandi's work. These are the pictures that I get the most of. So I just thought I would go over that. But right now we're going to go to Pinterest. Dun, dun, dun. I love Pinterest. So let's just go through a couple pictures. And I'm going to, let's see.
Hold on 1 second.
So, making sure you guys are okay. So I got another picture pulled up. Let me turn this AirPlay back on. Why isn't it showing here? Hey, why is this not showing? Hold on, y'all. AirPlay tripping. Technology. Why is this not working? There we go. Okay. I'm trying to show y'all a picture. Oh, maybe I can't do that. Okay, hold on, y'all. Hold on. We the boys. Okay, let me get y'all a couple hair pictures then. 1 second. So we're gonna do a little theory. We're gonna look at some pictures. And we're gonna go over the face shape because I get this picture a lot. A whole lot. Let's see. Hold on, y'all. And so I wanted to do this because, like I said, just learning how to see what people are looking for is everything. Because then, you guys can have, you and the client can have a great conversation about what you like, you know, what you want to see, and where they are. Big deal. Because a lot of times customers want things that you're like, ma'am, you're not a candidate for that. And so here's how we can become a candidate for that, right? And so I'm just gathering a couple of pictures because it's not letting me stream. I don't know why. I was just going to go on Pinterest. Let's see. Hold on, y'all. Put your questions in the chat box, by the way. If you are looking for some support, put your questions in the chat box. I would love to answer questions at the end of this session. And the funny thing, we're going to talk about Halle Berry. I just want y'all to know, most people, I'll crack up. Everybody loves Halle Berry hair, but Halle Berry wears a lot of wild spikes. It's very messy. She also has, you know, a very soft, wavy texture hair. She sticks it up in the air. It's very wild. Super cute. Very sweetheart. I'm giving you guys all right, so let me go back to here and go to my screenshots. There we go. Boom. All right. Sorry about that, y'all. Making sure you guys have got in. Let me see what y'all doing. I see people chatting. I don't know what's going on with the live stream, y'all. Feminine quality. Perfect. I love the answers in the chat room. Love it. Love it. Love it. Okay. So when someone brings you this picture, when somebody brings it to me, I instantly go, okay. Let's look at your face shape. Let's look at your hair and see what also you like about this picture. Like I said, y'all, just get you. She's cute. So super, super cute. That instantly makes you want to look like her. Same thing if you look at Rihanna. You want to be Rihanna. You want to try her hair cute and all. Just like, what's the girl name? I forgot her name. She's Keke Palmer. Keke Palmer's hair. Her cut action was real old school, y'all. Just like the girl Anika on Empire. It was an old school cut. She had a flat box back with a little bang, but Anika was cute. So y'all gotta also know how to break it down and be realistic about what's happening. Like, those are boxy cuts on cute women, which makes it look modern. Be very, like, know how to decipher so that you can give people
what they're looking for. No shade at all, but just know how to decipher, because you need to be able to look at a cut and start talking about sectioning. So in this right here, immediately I'm looking, okay, we know it's like a faux hawk, mohawk type style. There's a tail back there. She's not really lined up. It's just kind of soft. That's shaved off, basically. And the hair has color. There's height and texture. It flips. This is like swooped forward and flipping up. Let's see. She still has a nice little curve there. So her face is still kind of framed. This is off the face. So when you go through the client, when you're speaking to them, just point it out what they're looking at so that they can be clear and let you know what they actually like about the picture. So face shape again. Mohawks always fit like a longer, kind of an oblong type shape face. So look at that and then look at your client and say, this is what she has. This is what you have. Look at their hair texture. If their hair texture makes a big difference. If the hair texture is too fine and it's real fragile, I don't recommend mohawks. Why? Because mohawks are something that you have to kind of put a lot of product, or you curl it, or I mean, you can roll it depending on how long the hair is, but then the roller gives it too much bump. Like finer hair that needs to just relax, let them know, like, I can give you this cut, but you're probably gonna go for something that's more laid down until we can, you know, flip it all back and faux hawk you backwards, okay? So looking at the hair texture is a big deal. Thick hair, mohawk all day. It stands up by itself. And using the cutting techniques that I taught you guys in previous classes on point cutting and doing the shorter pieces to make the hair stick up, that's gonna help you. Here's how you assess how to get this style. Look at what's happening. When she turned her head to the side, instantly I can tell there's a horseshoe parting with a triangle at the back. There's a small tail. Ask the client, do you want this tail back here? Do you want that? Okay, ask them, are they gonna be getting any color? The color sets this apart, right? And then just know that you're gonna take, there's the eyebrow, so a little bit above 3/4 of an eyebrow, depending on their face shape, that's gonna decide where you do the horseshoe parting. But a horseshoe parting around the head, section off that hair, right underneath that horseshoe parting, take an upside down triangle. Y'all see that shape? Section that off. You're gonna either scissor over comb, clipper, however you like it. I hate clippers, but if that's what the style want, they want that shaved look, then you're gonna clipper off the sides and then bring this down. And so then you're gonna work through and create your partings and create your texture. You could do a razor, you could do point cutting, you could take a section here at the top to get your spiky area and then pull all of this back, do a horizontal line here, hold this section up, take your point cut, razor, however you want to cut it, and then take another horizontal, pull it back, cut it to match. Another horizontal, pull it back, cut it to match. Another horizontal, pull it back, cut it to match. You got to ask them, how long do you want this? Okay? So back here, you would take this, pull it up to that horizontal line, cut it to match. Horizontal line, cut it to match. That's if you want it to be longer down here. If you want it to be shorter, you can just do 90 degrees and just blend it out. Okay? That's how you break down a picture to get where you're going to go. So watching the videos of Short Hair Bootcamp Live, you'll begin to notice the pattern. Most haircuts are like, they're not that different. Like, there's the same technique done on different ways to get different looks. So let's go over another picture. What technique would you use to get this look? You guys, first of all, let's talk about what's cute. She is, okay, she bomb. Look at them brows. Ooh, and the nude lipstick and the, girl, you bomb. She bomb, right? So then let's talk about what makes this cute. You guys in the chat room right now, tell me what makes this stand out. Tell me, how would you get this look? All right, in the chat room, I'm waiting for you. I know it's a delay. Lynn, your music video keeps popping up. Not sure what you're talking about. I don't know what's going on with the internet today, y'all. No clue. But I do know that when you go and actually go to the same site 100 times, you have to constantly clear your cache. If not, it's gonna start trying to think ahead of you and say where you are, and it's gonna memorize, so it won't update the information. So you have to always clear your internet cache all the time. So let's see. Let's see, let's see. Let's see. All right. I'm waiting for you guys in the chat room. The Valentine, the partying, I love it, LaTanya and Brandy. Right, Valentine, right there. If you guys don't know what the Valentine is, when I first started the short hair bootcamp, we made that up. So this looks like a upside down heart. If I were standing from there and decided to just draw a heart, that's what it would be. So 3/4 of an eyebrow. I always tell you guys, that's what makes everything cute. So this is a mold. That's a mold. And you run the iron through it, kind of silk it out. And this looks like the day after or something like that. Like, her hair looks very soft, looks fine, looks like she has a soft, fine texture. This is cut very short. She kept her sideburns to the bottom of her earlobe. You can tell that there's some texture there. So it's a pixie cut. It's soft. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like a 90-degree haircut with some texture tips, point cutting. So begin to go through styles. Your assignment today is to go through styles and figure out what makes it pop. Because the more you can just flip through them and get your technique down. So for this style, what's your cutting? Your cutting is horseshoe section, 90, 90, 90, all the way. At the very top, bring it back, 90. And it's the same thing. It's an even 90 across the top. And then you're going to go through and just point cut. I know I'm talking over this. There are videos where I do this. We need to actually particularly do this look. So we're going to do that. I'm going to let me heart this. And we're going to do that in the Short Hair Bootcamp Live. Let's talk about this. I think that's the lady in Atlanta. Let's talk about this picture. What makes it cute? Besides her and her cuteness, we have the, again, face framing. And if you really look, this is not like super, you got little hairs there. It's very messy. It's very, you can tell there's not a lot of product in the hair. So most of this trending looks don't have a lot of product. They're not row by row curls. So you can see she still has a nice kind of wave outline. This is probably a couple days old hairstyle, right? And there's height, there's pixie, it's texture, it's messy, it's just tussled through. Tussled through hair is really what's selling. It's always sold to me, but you know, now it's becoming super, like, now clients get that they don't have to have row by row. And actually, I think it's more the professional woman doesn't want row by row. Some people, like, you know, in the hood areas, they be wanting to crunch by crunch. But this is what, and it's what has always sold for people looking for Halle Berry type stuff. You're rocking your cut. You're not rocking the roll by roll curl. Because guys, styles, I tell my clients all the time, your cut has to be right. If it's not, when your style gets old, you're stuck like Chuck because your haircut is not cute. This is a result of a cute cut, okay? And she's kind of long. I mean, look, she got all the hair over the ears, below the earlobe. She got a lot of hair right here. That sometimes does and does not work for certain people. So this is where knowing your skills and knowing the head shape, because if you have a little head, this will be too much hair. You're gonna look like a little elf or something, a little Elvis. So guys, know the head shape. A smaller face does not need this much hair in the sides. If you have a bigger face, like I have a bigger face, when I wear a relaxer, I could do that. Like I could totally do that perfectly fine because I have a big head. So just knowing she has like a lot of head space up in here. And I always tell people, your circumference, you gotta learn how to say things to them. If their hair is fine and they want it to stick up, you're gonna have to use the short, stick cutting the shorter pieces into the top so that it makes the hair stick up, but also letting them know, don't use a lot of product because it's gonna weigh your hair down. It's not gonna stand up like that, you know? And using something like the Like Sebastian spray to let the hair, you know, stand up, and still have texture and be cute a couple days later. So again, how would you do this haircut? It's still a 90 on the sides. This is a fuller top, so a little bit longer at the top, okay? Let's see, there's some shorter, there's some longer, there's some shorter, so take go through and have fun. She curled this, it's just running the iron through, finger styling. There's a little flip up there, there's a flip over there, there's a flip over, flip back, flip up. That's how I assess the curls. On this, this is bring the I would take my iron, run it towards the face, and then flip it up to get that look and spray it with some Sebastian spray. I see this picture a lot. People like this. First of all, she cute. She got that whole thing that's trending online with the long, long nails and a bunch of rings and a bunch of lashes. She just cute, right? So you'd be like, oh, I want to look like that when I take my selfie. That's what we do. We compare ourselves. And then let's look at what she's rocking. She has a wavy texture hair. So she has enough edges to where she can push her hair back. A lot of people do not have edges right here. So you have to go through your client and assess, does she have, is that gonna be appealing to her? And you talk to her and you have to, guys, when we're talking to our customers, it's like, okay, so this is super cute. I love the height here, it's off to the side. It's kind of reminding me of Megan Good, but Megan had hers on her face. This is off the face. Do you like your hair off the face? Key question that I always ask my customers, and I wrote this down, I meant to say this earlier, is what don't you like? What is the thing that you do not want to see on your hair? That is the question you need to ask at the beginning. Okay? What don't you like? What don't you like? Alexa says, preach. So, yes. Yes, Brandy, we can. So, asking them what don't they like will help you tremendously. Okay? So, a key part of this is when hair is off the face, and ask them, is that what they're looking for? Clients, a lot of times, they don't know what they want. They just think she cute, and they want to be cute. That's what they want. They want to feel confident, and they want to be cute like these women, right? Here, this is actually a very good stab at the Halle Berry, because to me, it makes me instantly think about Halle Berry. And why? Because she has the flips going up, and she has some going forward. She has the Valentine here. It's very smooth, nothing major. She looks like a rock star. She kind of looked like Halle Berry, little bitty face. So she's just cute. This works. This is still a 90 degree haircut with a longer front. Very simple. So knowing how to assess what you're going to do helps you feel so confident. When somebody brings me this picture, same thing. There's our Valentine. There's a little, here's something that I do all the time that's very important. A lot of times customers want the hair off the face, but it doesn't appease their forehead. So what you do is just bring one of those curls around. It's off the face, but you're bringing it around here, right? Up on the forehead area. Because what happens is it creates this, watch this. One, two, three. It creates a connector, which actually brings in this part of the face. So this one, two, and then this little area is three. So this is your Valentine. This is three quarters. Look at her eyebrow. Three quarters of an eyebrow, three quarters of an eyebrow. That is the key to short, cute, pixie hair. Three quarters of an eyebrow, three quarters of an eyebrow. I know I stress this a lot. I say it every class. Even though there's no parting there, this is still three quarters of an eyebrow, even though it's not on the face. Even though this isn't coming forward, this is actually coming backwards. It's still three quarters of an eyebrow. Three quarters of an eyebrow. There's a little piece right there in the front, and then it's three quarters of an eyebrow, but it's still off the face. If they want off the face, a lot of times this does not look appealing on people. Most, especially my clientele is 50 and up. Most of them, you know, we all hang about age. So that is not cute. So learning how to give them this, but compromise, right? Always go in right there and just take a little piece. It don't take much, a little section, and swoop it across the front. And it's what, how you do that is you're gonna take this and curl it going back. The very tip, just bring it down. You gotta learn how to work your fingers, okay? Same thing on Hallie. Look at that. That's going across the front of our forehead. That's a lot of spikes. Customers always say they want Halley stuff, and they actually do not want their hair standing up like that. I can't say, I'd be like, I want to do the spikes, but they'd be like, oh no, it's too. I will literally do this exact style, and they say, okay, take the spikes out. I say, you know, Halley got that. And they say they want the spikes at the beginning of the consultation, and there's nothing wrong. You just got to say, are you sure? Now go back to the picture, because you want to let them know, like, this is what you picked out. I'm listening to you. So this is what you have. This is what she has. You want me to take that out? Yes. No problem. Smile. No problem. It's just communication. You can never get offended. Don't get personal. It ain't personal. It's not about you. Give people what they want. And they typically, a lot of times, change their mind at the end. And you have to be okay with fixing your work. That's why you got to study and know hair textures and product uses. Because if you put too much product while you're curly, and then they want to change something, that's not good. What makes this cute? Again, the waves, just like on Kamandi style. All you got to do, like when I started obsessing over short hair, all I studied, I keep telling y'all, was 100,000 Halle Berry pictures. That's all I studied. And I see, this is coming down on the forehead, but then this is going up. That one's kind of going that way. That one's going forward, forward, up, up, backwards, 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 messy. There's nothing happening. That's messy. That's just a tussle through. Where is it? 3/4 of an eyebrow. So you'll begin to just see the same thing. These are different pictures. Same thing. She got some color there. Y'all sell some upservice color services. Little flick there, little flick there, flick up, flick up. It's just messy, cute flicks. You need to have these memorized in your mind. Super cute. This is actually shorter. Look at that spike right there. And there's a spike right there. Spike, 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 spike. Over. Like it's just super soft though. Okay? So knowing the key things that your short hair needs, that your short hair, like your technique, there's a formula. That is the like 3/4 of an eyebrow. Paying attention to if they need that little piece of hair on their forehead, they may need a lot of hair on their forehead and then going back. You got to pay attention to that. Brandy had a good question. She said, wait a minute. What did I just do? 1 second. Hold on, y'all. What's happening? What did I just do? Okay, so Brandy had a great question. She says, let's see. Brandy says, oh my God, you're breaking this down. It's all true. Yes, guys. So like, this is what I love. I love formulas. I love systems. And we got to be able to know how to speak to a customer. And you got to speak. You got to train your brain to see the formula. Short hair is very, that's why I was like, this needs to be taught. And I start, there's a formula and it's very easy to follow. We can pull up a million other pictures. You're going to be able to start looking and seeing. Remember that flower I teach? That's the flower. Remember I teach that all the time in Short Hair Bootcamp Live. That's the flower. You still got 3/4. This is coming forward a little bit towards the head and then going up. There's your Valentine there. There's spikes kind of forward, up, up, forward. A little bit of gray hair blended in with some brown highlights. 90-degree haircut. A little more length back in there so you can kind of full hop that. To give it a great profile. Does it? Like knowing, like look at that. That's a lot of spikes. Spikes, 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 spikes. And flip ups. Those are just all going backwards. But what makes it super cute is that there's that little hair. Boom. There's it. Like just knowing how to assess. Here's the Kamandi look. That's Halley, but that looks just like that picture Kamandi did. There's a little tussle. This is shorter. Still a 90-degree haircut. That's all it is. So I just wanted to go over that with you guys so that you can understand how to assess the haircut and know what, how to assess the picture and know what cut. You look at it, you say, what makes it cute? How do I transfer that to my customer? The answer is always make those Valentines. When they come from under the dryer, it never fails. My customers come from under the dryer, they're instantly going, "Ooh, I look cute." I know why they feel like they look cute. I always give them a Valentine. Always. It makes our face, no matter what shape, look amazing. So get your Valentine life together, child, and give your customers what they need to be cute. So Brandy is saying, can we go over blending the crown with the front at some point during class? Blending the crown with the front. So, and I don't even know one more. I didn't think of answering that kind of question, but of course. So Brandy wants to blend the crown. This is the crown of the head, the high point of the head. So if this is where we're cutting, but she's this long in the front, she's saying, how do we blend this? The way that you blend this, uno momento, por favor. Oh, please.
Oh, yeah. I don't even have, I'm not in my studio today.
And I purposely decided to take all my hair stuff away from my home so that I can have balance. There's no such thing as balance, but you know what I mean. So people can't pop and try to get their hair down. I'm like, ooh, I ain't got no material. So if this is the crown of the head, in order to blend this area, all I'm doing is taking horizontal partings and bringing them up. Now, if you want this to be longer, you're going to over-direct back. When you pull it back, it's going to be longer towards the front. But if you see, when I pull it back, you can kind of see that everything is, you see that texture? Everything begins to blend. All you're doing is taking your time and bringing this back to match the first piece that you cut. And when you bring all of this back, it's going to blend with that first piece that you cut. But when you let it go, you have a transition. Like it graduates slowly to the front in a blended manner. Same thing when you go from the side. If you decide to just take vertical partings, you over direct back and you point cut from the shortest piece, you're gonna cut to the longest piece. You take a little bit of this section, a little bit of a new section while you're working in that vertical line. You can either hold it straight up and blend it, or you can lean it back and blend it. Short piece to the longest piece. Now, depending on the cut that you're doing, how you cut that is going to be up to you. If you're just trying to do all over match, you just want to cut it in one direction. But typically, you always want to leave a little bit longer piece at the front. So it's just about bringing it back and cutting to that shorter piece. The length always varies depending on the look that you're trying to do. So if you're trying to get, let's see, if you want this look, you are going to, first of all, this section right here, that's super short. So you immediately will go, matter of fact, we're gonna do this next week. Next week we're gonna do that. That's important because I've gotten that question enough to make it be super, super like a focal point. Immediately, I know this top needs to be short. So since if I make the top that short, I'm just gonna 90 degree all of that on the sides all the way around. And then I'm gonna take my section here and pull everything back to that short piece. Okay? I'm gonna do that all the way to the front. After I do that all the way to the front, I'm gonna take that same piece that I cut, that's my guide. I'm gonna take a vertical line. So I'm gonna take a line right down the front of the head, part off this area out the way, part this area on the other side of that line out the way, to where I'm just working with this little middle section, and I'm going to make sure that that blends to that shortest piece. So what does that mean? I have to actually cut this off to match that piece in the back. That's my guideline. You can make the guideline travel and you just matching that guideline all the way to the front, or you can over direct back. You can over direct forward. I don't know. Like it depends on the cut that you're doing. So I hope that makes sense. You're going to always, I always match my little crown piece. That short piece was brought back. That goes back, that goes back, that goes back. And that gives you a gradual pixie here. And then all you just lay that other hair down. And then once you get this section going, you just cut to the, you bring everything up to that section. It literally is knowing the head shape, because that's what I do. Once I cut my guy here, I can literally start a haircut by taking this and cutting it short and do the entire head. If I, like, try that. That's one of my favorite cuts to do. One of my favorite cuts to do. Taking the head shape and cutting it right, like, literally, I can start a haircut. And I did that class before in the Short Hair Bootcamp Live area. We started with this, and then we just brought everything up to match all the way around the head. My favorite thing to do is work on diagonals, because it always works for any head shape. It always works. If you see me looking up here, I'm just trying to make sure you guys can see. I really should have this over there. Anyway, so it's all about the head shape, the shape of the head. So if I'm cutting and matching everything to the center of the head, that profile is going to be epic, because it's, even though it's the same technique, it's a different head, so it's going to look good on her head. Because I'm taking from this, in my brain, I see lines. And so from here, I see a line there. I see a line there. I see a line 360, like arrows pointing all the way out of the whole head. I just see, and so everything matches that, and it's super cute. And then you have to know how to texturize. Point cutting, slide cutting, razor cutting, all of that kind of stuff. So guys, let's go back over from the top. When you are, you're welcome, Brandy. Brandy says to answer her question. I'm looking forward to the next video of this picture. Yay, next week. So, okay. Let's go back over from the top. We're talking about how to get these looks and how to communicate them to the customer. First of all, I wanted you to understand how to even know what's making that look cute, because that's a big deal. You gotta know how to break down a picture so that when it's time to perform, meaning when it's time for you to do the cut, you gotta know how to do it. And it's about assessing the head shape. Now, her head is small. If your client got a big head, you need to be like, no, wait a minute, pause. She still has a longer chin. So these things, and that gives her chin symmetry, right? So just knowing, and she just has the whole glam thing with the, you know, expensive glasses, the purple lipstick, the, like knowing what makes that picture cute, and then really being real with your clients, like, what do you love about this picture? What don't you want to see? Like, what is the thing that you do not like? Not about the picture, but just what don't you like on your hair? I hate when my hair is sticking up. I don't like spikes. Or, you know, I like a tussle. Or I like row by row. Like, you got to ask these questions. And that's when you decide, that's when you develop a relationship with your customers, because then you can start assessing and being real about what's going on. This picture in particular, let me tell you guys, because y'all send me this picture a lot. Her sides, this is longer than this. This is very short. This area is very pixie. This is actually longer. So 2 inches in at least, you want to leave that stuff longer than you would this. That's going to give you that look more so. And then right up in here, you're not really, you got to let that leg, you got to do a nice mold. You got to have a nice relaxer. You got to have a nice black color. Like, all those things make that pop. Neckline is hugging. Everything's hugging the neck area there. That's important. Okay, guys? So, have a clean eye at your area, at your station. I learned that from Matrix. They always said, just, you do not need to have crap everywhere, because that's going to make your customer nervous. Unconsciously, they're just like, jeez, their nerves are bad. So, make sure you have a clean eye. Make sure that your first impression is amazing. Like, greet them, sit them down, look them in the eye when you're talking to them, ask them questions about their lifestyle, talk about their hair texture as it relates to this. Do you have wavy hair? Do you have kinkier hair? Do you have hair that needs to be, you know, as heat-free as possible because it's broke down? Do you have edges? Like, go over what the customer has and then go over what they want from this picture. And then ask them for a couple of pictures, because one picture typically doesn't do it. I always like to see a couple So then, because once you look at a couple, you as the expert is going to notice a common denominator. And typically the common denominator is the thing that I went over today 100 times in every picture. It's this. That's the common denominator. I promise you, I promise you, I promise you. It's typically just how feminine those areas look. It really does frame the face. So just know that a lot of the, thank you, Lynn. Thank you, LaVon. A lot of the confidence gets shaken because you need to get really clear on how to come up with a formula for a haircut really fast. If you send me a haircut right now, I can tell you how to get it just by looking at it. That's why I have Short Hair Bootcamp Live. You got to be able to do that so that when people come in your chair, you can execute. Because you ain't got but 30, I don't allocate but 30 minutes to a cut. You know what I'm saying? Like, you need to be, and it's going to be accurate. It's going to be dope. It's going to be delivered. There are tricks. There are shortcuts. But I know my stuff, and I move. I know my body position. I know my shears. I know my sectioning like the back of my hand. If I could just cut hair all day, I would. Everybody would be wearing messy hair. I would not be spending time row by row curling. I think that's stupid. I don't care for curls. If I relax my hair today, which I've been thinking about it, if I relax my hair today, I'm just going to wear my cut messy. Like, I could care less about curls, because who cares? You got to go to sleep, child. Go swimming a couple times a week. I'm going to be on the beach. Anybody got time for curls? They don't last. You got to educate your customer on what works for them, their lifestyle. You got to give them the right products. This consultation process will easily send them into buying retail from you, because they're going to be like, okay, girl, well, how do I manage this? Girl, okay, let me tell you now, this is the mold. See, I'm gonna cut your hair right so that when you gotta just go, you can go back to this comfortably. You can do that, girl, because I'm gonna teach you. I got the phone wrap for you, got the shampoo for you. Boom, you just up your ticket. You gave a haircut and you gave some products. Your ticket went from 55 to 95, plus the phone wrap was 10, plus the shampoo too for 25. Boom. Like, that's how you get your tickets should be like that. Your customers, you have to educate them. We have really jacked up mentality. A lot of stylists be saying, like, on my pages and stuff, you shouldn't be teaching the customers that. And I think it's absolutely hilarious. Hell yeah, I'm teaching my customers how to do their hair, because they need to know how to look cute in the streets. And they need to be able to go work out and go swim and go have them a wild night. And they can put their hair back together in the morning, okay? So for you who think that, you know, they're going to leave you, that's a lack mentality. We're going to talk about that in my upcoming conference, the CEO Stylist, because your lack mentality keeps you not happy and in the red, okay? So, again, looking at hairstyles and assessing the head shape, the things that make you cute, ask your customer, how long do you want your sideburns? Do you like the volume? Do you see that that's messy? Do you see that that's just tussled through? It's not really like any, like, is that what you're looking for? If they say no, then girl, let's go to Pinterest and find us some more shortcuts, okay? So that's all about the consultation. Looking at the hair structure. People want Halle Berry hair, but they ain't got Halle Berry wavy. So Halle Berry has wavy, soft tech. Like, she's like, her hair is wavy. So it ain't this right here. This right here, like, it's not happening. Okay, so understanding what they have, understanding what the client has, and relaying that, okay? So I hope this was super helpful to you guys. I absolutely love assessing hairstyles. I could do it all day because it's just fun for me, and it's what I love to do, and yeah, that's it. So I hope this was super, okay, let's go over another one too, because I know you guys, this looks familiar. Who did this hairstyle? This looks familiar. Let me show you guys a couple more. Because we didn't do any wavy ones, so let me just make sure y'all get the wavy part down pat. So, I can't remember who. Is that Kim? I think Kim did this. That's my boo, Kim. I think Kim did this, y'all, in Dallas. If I'm not mistaken, Kim did this. And she's in Dallas at Diva Style Salon. I do her website stuff. So anyway, this, let's assess. There's a part there. These are the questions you gotta ask. And
Yes, Johanna. Yes, yes, yes. Round and diagonal. I don't know that that's just, it's not really, it's not always round because you're cutting to the head shape. So it's round at some points, diagonal at some points, point cutting. Johanna was asking, cutting from the middle would be round cut layers. Is that right? Pizzas. Definitely like pizza, which gives you triangle sections, which gives you diagonals, and it gives you round. It gives you everything. So I always say be tied to the head shape and the cutting technique, not so much like, because the words confuse people, depending on where you learn your cutting terminology from. Like Paul Mitchell has their own, Tony and Guy has their own, Vidal has his own. So that's another class. But let's assess this really quickly. Okay, this is very soft. She has hair here. Always ask your customer how they want their nape area. Always ask them how they, I got one client, she like insists on her sideburn going back towards her ear. She don't play. Curl that backwards. Like she likes it curl like that. So here, this is just you can tell that it was a wave mold and then it's just softly bumped. Here's a little, they're wispy. They're not all the way pin curled. So point that out to the customer. Okay, this is not all the way. This is like a wispy. And then show them a contrast and say, well, this picture has a pink curl look. This one has like a wispy, it's edgy tips. It's very soft. She has a longer bang here. It's very Megan Good-like, right? Okay, so this cut is still a 90 degrees. It's actually kind of like you can 45 this because there's a little bit of weight there. And then it's kind of in right here. So you could actually 45 this and then from here, blend it. Take this back to blend to the shortest piece from, and it's gonna go from short to long. And then you're just gonna curl it in different tussles. That's it. You see it's going over the eye, 3/4 of an eyebrow. There's our little wannabe, you know, Valentine right there. It's going over that way. There's some flip ups, there's some flip overs. It's very soft. And she cute, makeup cute, jawline, all of that just matches. Everything makes her head shape look super cute. And let's see, let's look at this one. First thing I noticed about this picture is smooth out with Photoshop, so y'all beware. I don't know who picture this is, but that's smooth, that's a lot smoothing and boosting. And Facetune. So be careful, guys, don't over Photoshop your pictures. That's the thing that's not integrity. It sells customers false dang hope. Because the mold is not as smooth. That's not curled. That's a wavy. And it's no shade to whoever did this. But let's just assess and let's see what's real. There's some flip-ups. There, it was waved in a mold. And there's just a lot of pretty. These are very pretty curls. They're a little bit tighter. They're on base. The waves are not really curled on the side. So ask your customer, do they want their hair to stay in the mold of the wave and for you to just curl around it? It's kind of curled in a faux hawk, so mohawk style. So this is going up. These are flipping back towards the middle. That's down. That one's going up. That one's going up. That one's going down. That's going away from the wave section. So it's just a matter of assessing. At all times, you're just assessing. And yeah, that's just fun on base curls. Really, really pretty. Very, very pretty. So I hope this helps you guys. And yay. I love the comments. Johanna says, thanks, it's helping me. Everyone knows pizza, LOL. Very true. Brandy says, LOL. Lynn says, can't wait until the next video. You're awesome. Thank you, Lynn. LaVon says, great demo. Brandy says, yay, thank you. You answered my question. Look forward to the next video. Yay. Brandy says, Alyssa says, preach. Let's see, Brittany, you were giving advice about which, not advice, but you were guessing if the cut was a 90. This cut, this is still a 90 degree haircut. There's a little bit of weight here, so you can do this section kind of still 90 degrees, but take a pie shape and kind of make this section a little fuller, which means you're gonna just cut it a little longer, not super short, but a little bit longer, and make sure the length is consistent throughout, and then it kind of goes back to a regular straight 90, but blends, right? I hope that makes sense. So you're blending this short to long, kind of one length there. So it just kind of weighted. Sides are shorter, 90 degrees, a little fuller sideburn, so leave about an inch in this area and texturize that so that it's nice and wavy. Her sideburns come to the bottom of her ear.
So you got to look at pictures and assess where things stop so that you can stop it at the same place on the client, right? So that's what I wanted to just really talk to you guys about today. This class was all that. Thanks, Keisha. Yay! Yay, yay, yay. So we're done. Did I cover everything on my notes? Yes. Guys, and the last thing is confidence. Just have confidence. My sign says, believe you can, and you're halfway there. It is about belief in yourself. And when you don't think you can do it, I'm telling you, lean on me. Like the song say, lean on me when you're not strong. Act like I got your calm. And I'm right there carrying along. Like, act like I got your comb and your scissors and cut as if I was there, like, right? Or find somebody that you admire and act like they're the ones holding the comb. They're the ones giving the consultation. They're the ones that create this beautiful art. And I just encourage you to create, have fun, and communicate with your customers. This is a big deal. This is why I am, like, doing well in the salon. I love to have this conversation. Let's talk about where you are. Let's talk about where they are. Let's talk about where you want to go. And let's talk about what it is that you want to see and what you don't want to see. From those questions, you will be so much more confident. So this week in the salon, I challenge you to approach everything this way. And I want to know in the comments, in the Facebook group, you know, email me a question at shorthairbootcamplive.com. Like, send me your reports. I want to know how it's going when you're having these consultations. You should have a much clearer way to communicate. I need y'all to show up to work professional. When you are cute, you sell more shit, period. That's just the way it go. When you cute, you sell more stuff. That is the way it goes. So let's see. Latanya says, same, Keisha. Johanna says, styling the top session is difficult for me. How to get the messy look but still structured neat, if that makes sense. That makes very, very much sense. So you got to use the Sebastian spray, and we'll go over that next week. But the Sebastian spray is very good at giving you a nice hole, but still fluffy and messy. When you curl, that flower that I teach all the time in all the videos, when you get that right and you use the Sebastian spray, when it comes time to just run your fingers through it, it actually makes it really easy to run your hands through and give that look and give it messy to where it still has structure. The Sebastian helps it hold structure softly so that you can add the texture but then mess it up and it still holds. Okay, so sounds like I should add extra 15 minutes on top of 30 minutes cut. Yeah, take your time with your haircut. You know, take your time until you got it down pat. Hey, Alexis, I specialize in techniques for alopecia. Latanya says she specializes in techniques. Oh, so there was an alopecia question. So here's the deal. Back to the consultation. That's a good question. If your client has alopecia, I got clients, I posted their pictures. They don't have hair here. They don't have hair here. So it's just a matter of assessing what they have, where the holes are. And I used to do like weaves on people who don't even have any hair, like right here. And letting them know like what styles work for them, what they need to do to keep this area laid, what that cut looks like. When there's hair, like my client that doesn't have hair here, I always elevate everything up so that when it goes back down, it covers. And we keep that section for the most part nice, and I wave it nice. And she likes the fillers in her hair. Some of my clients don't need the fillers. When the wind blows, it's still there. Fillers are, some people look at that like it's negative. I had somebody say like, oh, no fillers on my client. Guess what? Fillers don't rinse out in the freaking ocean. When you add fillers, customers think you're the bomb. That is an upsell. That is an upgrade. You will be surprised when celebrities get fillers. When I've done commercials, like, they get fillers, and they, if you don't have it, they're going to be pissed at you. So for those of you who say, oh, no comb on my style or no filler, like, there's no real rules. It's what works for you. And I think that we need to stop being so competitive and just be like, you know, whatever works for the customer, whatever makes them happy. And so, like, for a lot of my alopecia clients, they love their fillers because they want spikes and they want their hair to stick up. Or they don't even want spikes and it's not going to move, but they just want to feel confident there. And then knowing what styles can cover their areas comfortably. Also, if they need extensions, you know, finding something that works for them where it's not pulling out their hair. I use the beaded method. It's very soft, which I'll have to show you guys that for some clients because they are adamant about things that they want. So it's just, it really depends on the client. It really does. And it depends on how real they are with where they are, where they want to go, and how real you are with what you know how to do. And if you don't know how to do it, finding an expert, LaTanya, she just put her number there, finding somebody who works with a lot of alopecia clients who can enlighten you. And don't ask them to do it for free all the time. Like, if you ain't got nothing to offer them, like, get in there and see what they have, and then, you know, go from there. But let's see. LaTanya's putting her number in the chat room for those who want to talk about alopecia. Awesome. So that's what this is about, guys. The Facebook group, that's about community. That is a community-run group. I don't run that group. You run that group. If you want to share yourself, you want to motivate, like, that's so that you can be around like-minded people. Yes, I'm going to be in there, and yes, I'm going to answer questions. But it's about how active you are. So shout out to, like, Gwen, Brandy, Toya. You guys are in there just blowing it up. LaKeisha, Val, like, you guys are amazing in the group. And you're just being authentic, and I can tell that's how you really are in your everyday life, just sharing and helping people. So shout out to everybody who is building community, you know? And on that note, we're about to bounce out. Making sure, yes, Johanna, we'll do more extension styles, for sure. Like, we just, this is gonna go on forever and ever until y'all just decide to go away. I'm gonna be here, I'm gonna be teaching. I enjoy teaching you guys so much, and I am grateful for you. I love to share, so whatever I can, please never hesitate. I look at all the messages, and it just gets queued up. It's like I got so much to catch up on from last year's questions. So just know that I'm listening. I always want to hear where you are, what you're frustrated with, what you need help with. Make sure you send any questions, any issues, any support, email question@shorthairbootcamplive.com. When you guys send emails to Facebook, to my other, like, only email question, that's the name of the, so question@shorthairbootcamplive.com. That's the email address. That way, Lynn, I will add you to the Facebook group. You should have gotten the invite. There are like literally 100 invites on Facebook that people have not answered. So it's a private group. FYI, this is not a group for some stylists who have been doing hair for 20 years to come in and try to, you know, be teachers and stuff, build your community and do that on your time. This is not that place. I've had several people complaining about people inboxing them trying to sell them stuff. This is not a place for you to come pick up people. Like, you have to pull your own weight and build your own people and community and tribe, okay? So if I'm not promoting y'all don't listen. So, and that's no shade, it's just truth. That's like not what that's for. This is not for you to market your product. It's for us to learn and grow together. I always give advice, I always share, you know, that's what it's for. What else? I think that's it. Email, the right email address so that you don't get overlooked. And I see you guys this week in the community group. This week, it's our power rally week for the CEO stylist. There's going to be a lot of free content I'm giving away, so make sure you guys check that out. I'll remind you guys via email, on Facebook, blah, 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 on YouTube. But I'm giving away a whole lot of great content today. So you'll get that reminder. That's for the upcoming event in August 24th, and there are going to be many more events like this. And I'm going to go grab some coffee and another meal before I go live for the CEO stylist. In the CEO stylist, we are talking about the characteristics of a CEO stylist. And we're talking about building, expanding, and exploding your business. Okay? I know a little bit about it. Everything I do runs off the internet. You would not be here if you did not find me on the internet. Isn't that cool? We have hundreds of people that just communicate from all parts of the world from the internet, all because I decided to make noise and explode my business, right? So I want to teach you how to do that. And I want to teach you about the traits that you got to have and that I picked up from the beginning that changed my career and the life that I'm able to live now. It's not a brag thing. I get to live in the place that I love, rooftop pool. I live across the street from the beach. And it's because I definitely changed my mindset. That was the first thing I did. First thing I did was change my mindset. So we're going to talk about the characteristics of a successful CEO. And success is relevant to what you want. I want those things. I moved here to live by the beach. So I was very adamant about it and I got what I wanted. Now I'm like, okay, I've done that. I can live in another state now. I can live anywhere in the world because I understand the internet. I understand building, expanding, and exploding my brand. I understand how to fill the seats. No matter what state I'm in, I can fill the seats. Like that's something that you have to know how to do. And it all starts with your mental. So that's what the CEO Stylist is about. We're also gonna do a haircut and style at that conference on October 24th. So you'll get more details about that via email. I'm excited to teach you guys. And for right now, I'm gonna take a break before I get into the next lesson. Thank you so much for spending your time with me. I don't take it for granted. I'm extremely grateful and I hope that you have. I'm gonna speak it that you have. You're gonna have an amazing week this week. This, what we just learned, is going to impact you this week. You're gonna hear my voice. You're gonna look at those pictures and see the things that we've learned. You are going to excel and up-level everything that you do this week. I believe in you. I challenge you. I'm LaKeisha Michelle. Thank you for watching ShortHairBootCampLive.com. If you're not a member, this is going to go private. So you got to watch. You got to get an example. If you want to watch the replays, if you want to watch the 30-plus videos of different styles, techniques, you know, just us in repetition learning the formula, you can log in. It's $19 a month. It will not be for long. As soon as my coach gives me the okay, I'm under mentorship. And when we're done, we're done, and prices go up because the value is insane. So right now you're in for 19 bucks. You can try it out, 30-day refund. That's it. That's all you gotta do, and that's it. So mwah. LaVon says bye. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I see you guys. How can we attend that class? You'll get that. The CEO Silence is gonna be a free live stream. The whole Power Rally Week is just information that's gonna let you know what's gonna happen at that live event. It'll be on Facebook, YouTube. I will send an email out to you guys when we go live. You'll get that information. You won't miss it. And I'm so glad that you're interested in it. Anyway, I'm out, guys.